Yo
Bueno,
comprendo un poco de español. Bueno.
hablo despacio entonces. Yo tengo una pregunta con respecto a la historia del Bodhisattva Dharmakara, en donde se cuenta que luego de él revelar sus votos a la audiencia, se escucha la voz del Dharmakaya Supremo que confirma que él con seguridad alcanzará la budeidad. ¿Cómo es posible eso, que se escuche la voz del Dharmakaya Supremo? Eso es lo que no puedo comprender.
It is about the larger sutra where Dharmakara was, he heard the voice from Dharmakaya. And how is that possible when Dharmakaya cannot be understood? It is beyond all our comprehension. Why is it that there was this voice that came and confirmed Dharmakara's vows at the end of that at the end of that larger sutra?
In the Gotoku's notes, Shinran said, and I give a quote, in the giving of witness to the primal vow, there are three bodies, the witness of Dharma body, ultimate Dharmakaya, and the larger sutra states, from the sky a voice declared in praise, you shall decidedly and without fail attain the supreme enlightenment. This was the witness of Dharmakaya, ultimate Dharmakaya. The witness of fulfilled bodies, Sambhogakaya Buddhas. This refers to the Buddhas of the 10 directions. And the witness of Nirmanakaya, this refers to Lokeshvararaja Buddha. So, Camila asked, how can Dharmakaya have a voice? So actually, that voice was a reaction of ultimate Buddha nature. It was a reaction of the ultimate reality itself. So this is what it was, a reaction. When you do something as a worldly person, you can have a reaction in the people around you. And you can also, if you have enough mental power, your voice can create reverberations or how can I say it in English? It can create waves. If you are powerful enough, your thoughts or your words or your actions will create waves in the area around you. Actually, everybody always influences the world around him. So whatever you do, think, and say creates like waves in around you. And the more powerful you are, and the more the more waves you can create around you. Dharmakara Bodhisattva was so honest in his aspirations, and he was so sincere in wishing to save everybody, and he was so determined in helping all beings, that his aspiration created an infinitely more powerful echo in all the worlds, you know, and it created it created also a reaction from everybody around him, from the nature, from the gods, from the Buddhas in the 10 directions. And it created like a reaction from the ultimate reality itself. Do you understand, Camila? Or can you translate, Peter?
Entendí. Ahí entendí.
Do you understand?
Sí. Sí, voy a continuar leyendo.
Así, sí. Sí, sí, understand.
Okay. It is very difficult to understand this because, I repeat, whatever we are saying, all our explanations in Buddhism are only hints. We can't actually understand everything about the Buddha with our limited mind. It's impossible. So this is just a hint of what actually happened. It was a reaction from the Buddha nature, from the ultimate reality itself. That was a reaction. You know, like for example, you are on a high mountain and you scream, you say, oh, and then the echo comes to you, oh, you see? You understand?
Yes.
Okay, so Dharmakara emitted the sound of his sincerity. He emitted his sincerity all over the universe. And then the echo came back to him from the ultimate reality. That's what happened.
Claro. Claro, okay.